To keep students safe from the dorms to the classroom to the cafeteria.
And we start with breaking developments on the coronavirus pandemic. Allegheny County leaders held a news conference within the last hour.
And it's happening on a day where the county's case count fell back into double digits. In the meantime, we learned there are 14 active coronavirus cases at the Shell Cracker construction site in Beaver County, but that amounts to a positivity rate of 1%, and Shell will continue to add workers. And the Big Ten became the first major college football conference to release its football schedule with a 12-week plan for 10 weeks of games. But the breaking story right now is what Allegheny County leaders are saying about the virus.
Channel 11's Aaron Martin joins us live. And Aaron, the cases are down, but there are still concerns.
Yeah, Lisa and Peggy, what we really heard from county leaders this afternoon was what sounded like cautious optimism. Cases, positivity rates, those are on the decline. However, with schools getting ready to return, that is creating some concern about what could happen over the next several weeks. Now, that news conference with Allegheny County leaders wrapped up just within the last 30 minutes or so, and County Executive Rich Fitzgerald encouraged districts to require students to wear masks and to social distance and making sure that is all maintained. Now, Fitzgerald says everyone must follow these guidelines to keep cases down, and that will be the best way to make sure that school districts and universities stay open. Now, Health Director Dr. Deborah Bogan also announced the COVID field response team visited more than 700 establishments, with 87% of them following all of the rules in place. That seems to be reflected in the recent data, with fewer people testing positive telling contact tracers they visited bars and restaurants.
The number of new cases reporting going to or working at bars and restaurants has dropped by half. Parties have dropped a little bit, and it's now about even with bars and restaurants. I need you all to be safe when you're celebrating with friends and family.
Now, Dr. Bogan also spoke about nursing homes, where we've seen cases rise over the last several weeks. She was asked whether that could be connected to somebody potentially testing positive, being asymptomatic, a staff member, and then infecting other residents. While she said it is very possible, at this point, it's still unclear what is causing those cases to rise. Reporting live tonight, Aaron Martin, Channel 11 News.